Ramadan Picks.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to another episode of Ramadan Picks. Today, inshallah, we will be talking about one of the Muslim heroes, a hero that died in this month of Ramadan. He was one of the greatest rulers that ruled in the Muslim Ummah. If you are asked, who is the greatest king of Europe? You would be surprised to know that it was actually a Muslim. The greatest king of Europe is a Muslim. And Spain, acknowledging that, celebrated 1,000 years of the death of Abdurrahman al-Nasir li dinillah rahimahullah. He was the Khalifa from the Umayyad dynasty in Al-Andalus, who declared the Khilafah in Al-Andalus in the year 316. He ruled in Al-Andalus for 50 years, from year 300 until year 350. When he started ruling, he was only 22 years old. That is our Muslim hero. He was 22 years old. Yet he was a great king, a great Khalifa. He declared the Khilafah in the year 316. You would ask yourself, what a 22 years old could do? Well, actually he did a lot. And he was a great example for a Muslim hero. Because when he ruled only Qurtuba, which was the capital of Al-Andalus. But everywhere else was divided. Everywhere else people were fighting one another. Muslims were fighting Muslims. And the Crusaders were killing Muslims. He didn't give up. He united the entire Andalus under his rule. And after that, he fought the Crusaders. And he was able to liberate a lot of Muslim land. And when he died, he left a great civilization, a great example of a Muslim hero, how a country should be run. That was Abdurrahman al-Nasir li dinillah, or Abdurrahman III. Because in Al-Andalus, there were three great rulers, all of them with the name Abdurrahman. The first one was Abdurrahman al-Dakhil, Abdurrahman ibn Muawiyah, rahimahullah. The second one was Abdurrahman al-Awsat, Abdurrahman ibn al-Hakam. And the third one is our hero, Abdurrahman al-Nasir li dinillah, Abdurrahman ibn Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdurrahman. That was the Muslim hero. He was raised by his grandfather. His father passed away in early age, so his grandfather raised him and he taught him the arts of heroism, the arts of being a real man, a real hero of a Muslim ummah. We can complain a lot in our time that our situation is bad, that we have a lot of difficulties, but actually their time was even more difficult. Their time, they had the Crusaders, three of the Christian kingdoms at the corner. And the Muslims were fighting Muslims. At our time, we could complain a lot, but we need those heroes, those who can provide the answer, those who can find a solution instead of just complaining. And this is a chance in this beautiful month of Ramadan, the same month that Abdurrahman rahimahullah passed away in. The beautiful example about Abdurrahman al-Nasir rahimahullah is that he was a king, but at the same time, he was also pious. He was righteous. He was a Khalifa, but at the same time, he was just. And it's very difficult to combine those two elements, the element of power and the element of righteousness, the element of riches and the element of obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. This is the component that is missing in our time. We need someone who works for the dunya, but without forgetting the hereafter. That was the example of Abdurrahman al-Nasir li dinillah rahimahullah. Even though sometimes he would feel that he transgressed, he would come back again immediately. He had one of the greatest scholars of Islam at his time, Al-Munzir ibn Sa'id rahimahullah. When Abdurrahman, the Khalifa, built his palace, the roof was entirely from gold. So when the scholar Al-Munzir ibn Sa'id rahimahullah came and reminded him that this is only what the kuffar would do, he immediately demolished that and changed it. So that's what we need in our time. Yes, we have a lot of righteous people. And yes, we have a lot of politicians, a lot of people who can do and run a lot of businesses. But who would be able to combine those two things? That's what we need in our time. Those are the heroes that we are looking for. So if he could do it, then you can do it as well. And inshallah, we will have them. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.